Ladies and gentlemen, last year's Cecil B. DeMille Cecil B. DeMille Award winner, Mr. Clint Eastwood.
When Hollywood Foreign Press Association asked me to present the Cecil B. DeMille Award, I couldn't possibly say no. Not only is this year's recipient an extraordinary gifted performer, worthy of this prestigious award, but she happens to be a neighbor of mine and a woman I've been in love with since I first saw her on the screen. Her name is Doris Day. Born Doris Kapiloff in Cincinnati, Ohio, she became a top box office woman star of all time. She ranked number one unequaled 5 years. Most people would be content having one successful career, but Doris has had six. She's been a band singer, radio, nightclubs, recordings, movies, and television. And as a singer, she's had 6 million selling records. She was one of the first successful music people to make it in motion pictures. Some would say it's magic. Romance on the High Seas made her an instant hit.
The stars desert the skies and rush to nestle in your eyes.
She then starred in Tea for Two, Lullaby of Broadway, I'll See You in My Dreams, and On Moonlight Bay. 1952, she teamed up with a handsome leading man in The Winning Team, in which she played the wife of baseball star Grover Cleveland Alexander. I doubt Doris knew at that time that her leading man would be the 40th president of the United States.
Can't you even talk to me anymore, Alex? After all we've been through together, you can tell me. You can tell me anything.
There's nothing to tell.
Darling, what's happened to you? You never drank before. Why now? All of a sudden, why? Alex. What are you afraid of?
Stop badgering me, you mean?
After appearing in April in Paris, and by the light of the silvery moon, she portrayed the rambunctious pistol-packing prairie girl, Calamity Jane, and it made her a superstar.
What's the matter with you? Don't you believe me?
Oh, sure. Only with you killing off them Redskins so fast, I was wondering why the government even bothered to send the army.
Calling me a liar again.
Why don't you ever fix your hair?
And she sang the song that won that year's Academy Award.
Once I had a secret love that lived within the heart of me. Dance. That's what they pay me.
The next milestone came when she agreed to play the life and the story of the late torch singer Ruth Etting opposite James Cagney.
Martin Snyder presents Ruth Etting. That way everybody'll know who's boss. Like you know. Like you better know. No matter how much you scream and holler and carry on.
What's the matter, Martin? Are you afraid you're losing your grip?
Love Me or Leave Me allowed Doris to shed her wholesome all-American girl next door image and prove she could be equally adept at a dramatic actress as she was in comedy.
Why didn't you tell me?
I wasn't sure until now.
Doris
impressed moviegoers in Alfred Hitchcock's thriller, The Man Who Knew Too Much. This time her leading man was James Stewart.
No.
In this film, she introduced her second Academy Award-winning song.
Future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera.
In her next series of films, Doris showed once again that she was one of Hollywood's best comedians, also one of the sexiest. All the Hollywood's legendary leading men, Rock Hudson, Cary Grant, Clark Gable, and James Garner.
Ooh. Rex? Rex, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Who was that?
Oh, my party lineup.
I know a restaurant in Paris where you can get some marvelous French food. Then we go to Monte Carlo.
In other words, just what are you after?
Well, that's pretty hard to put into words. To tell you the truth, I didn't want to come here in the first place. My boss.
Really?
What a great job I have, having to hug Doris Day. I've always felt that one of the luckiest things that I ever did in this business was doing two pictures with Doris. And I got to hug her, but there was one time I felt very badly about. I had to hug Doris, and it was in a scene where she was struggling with another actress, and of course it was a comedy scene, and I had to go over and grab her around the waist and pick her up and carry her off like a sack of flour. Well, I didn't think anything about it. The next day, the director comes up and he says, Jim, go a little easy on Doris today. I said, what's the matter? He said, well, she broke a rib yesterday. Well, she didn't break it, I did. She never said a word, came to work the next day, never said a word. I apologize, Doris. I didn't mean to hurt you. But tonight, I hope you enjoy yourself. Lois and I send you our love, and we wish you the best. You deserve it. Good night.
Doris, you're a remarkable woman. You put your heart and soul into everything you do, whether it's singing or acting or your incredible devotion to the well-being of animals. You were the girl every man wanted to marry and the woman every girl wished she could be. And after seeing you against opposite all those powerhouse leading men, my only regret is I never had the opportunity to be one of them. So on behalf of the board of directors of the Hollywood Foreign Press Association, I proudly present you the C.B. DeMille Award to Miss Doris Day.
Thank you, Clint. I don't know what to say. I really don't. I'm a wreck. You do this all the time, and I don't do it anymore. I live in the country, and I've got to come to town more often. I look around, and I can't believe all this talent. I'm in awe. I really am. And for me to be standing up here with this award, I don't understand it, but I love it. And I'm very grateful. And it's so marvelous to see all of you again. I've been away much too long. It's just been, this business has been a great joy in my life. I've loved every minute of it. And there are so many people that I would love to thank. All the fabulous leading men I've worked with, and Jimmy Garner was so dear, but I've worked with the cream of the crop. I'd love to work with you, by the way. And And every day, just going to work was exciting to me. I couldn't wait to get there and see all the guys. I have coffee and a donut. Yeah. All the guys in the crew, they were my family. And it's been a wonderful life, and I'm not finished yet. I think the best is yet to come. I really do, and I want to do some more. Yeah. It's just great to be here. I'm having a marvelous time, and I don't know how to thank the foreign press for this. It's overwhelming. But thank God. God is good, and I'm very blessed, and it's really good to see all of you. Thank you very much.
Awards for Best Motion Picture Musical or Comedy and Best Actor and Actress in a Motion Picture Drama when the Golden Globe Awards continue.